My name is Marco Baez. I've been a barber here in Elgin, established under my own business since 2014. When I first found out the news that we were gonna be shutting down, I was devastated. We were sitting here in the barbershop. It was a Saturday, March 21st, and I just remember the governor's press conference was on, and we were all sitting around seeing what was gonna happen. And the moment that he said that he was shutting everything down, my heart just dropped. And I just had a emptiness in my stomach, and I didn't know what I was gonna do, how I was gonna provide for my family, not knowing where we were gonna get the money to do groceries or to pay the bills. And a million things started to race through my head. I really had to just throw my hands up and kind of trust that it was all gonna work out, and that kind of had to listen to my wife telling me to just trust in the Lord and just calm down, everything was gonna be okay. So I've been at Harvest since 2013, and I'm super, super thankful for the people at Harvest. Just, we were getting meals at our house, we were getting groceries, we were getting gift cards, for grocery stores and stuff like that, and we were super blessed by that. They really helped us out. They really gave us some breathing room, so we were able to take care of the essential things that we needed as a family. Being a barber, I work a lot of hours. Sometimes I work, you know, most of the time I work late hours, and I get home late. Don't really get to spend a lot of quality time with my family, so. What was going through my mind the majority of the time was, you're never gonna get a chance to have this time back again. Just being able to pour into my family, my kids, just giving them that time that I've never been able to give them before, just uninterrupted, zero distractions, just quality time. Also, during that time, I had a friend who was going through some things, and I was really able to dedicate a lot of hours to him, just being there and just walking alongside of him through the whole situation. So, which I know that I probably wouldn't have been able to do if I was working a full-time job and dealing with the family, so on and so forth. We were able to open up May 29th, and since then, the appointments were rolling in and people really wanted to get their hair cut. We've pretty much been back to about 75% of our normal business intake. So the Lord has been really good to us during this time. We have actually gained a lot of new business just for the precautions that we take, such as making sure that we're washing our hands after each client, washing all of our equipment, wearing masks. And the people really seem to appreciate that and want to give us their business because we care so much about their health and their safety when they come here. Most of all, what the Lord showed me was just to trust Him and just to really put all my desires in His hands and just to watch what He can do with it. And I was really excited to see all that the Lord had done for us in hindsight, just to look back at it and see how we made it through. So I'm very grateful for that.